Hi, in this video we will learn how to implement SweetAlert into your website or into your web page. If you are using simple alert box, then you must have to watch this video because in this video we will learn how to display SweetAlert into your website. Right, so here you can see we created one live demo, so let's see that demo first. Right, so here you can see when I click on this button at the time this SweetAlert will display, and if you click on this then this type of SweetAlert will display. And if you want to confirm, suppose you want to delete some file and before you need to display this alert box, then you can use this confirm box. So this is a most useful SweetAlert, and I think this is the most beautiful SweetAlert, and I think this is the most useful SweetAlert, right? And here you can see you can also display your image in this SweetAlert. So here you can see you can also display your image inside this SweetAlert, right? You can also take input from this SweetAlert box, so you can also take your input from this SweetAlert. So how to implement this SweetAlert into your website? So first you need to create one simple file, right? And you can also follow our blog. Here you can see we already created every step, so you can also follow this blog, right? And I will share this blog link in my video description, so you can get this link from my video description, right? So here you can see you need to include SweetAlert library, right? So where to get this SweetAlert library? You can search SweetAlert. Here you can see this is a SweetAlert official document. So here you will get this link, right? So you can copy. I also shared this link from my video description, so you can also copy this code, right? So first you need to create one simple file. So and suppose we created one file like and save it on desktop, sweetalert.html, right? And then save it. Now you must have to start. Okay, so here we take one title like is equal SweetAlert, and then here we need to include our library, right? So first we take this library, so you can copy paste this code, right? But when you include this library, you must have to require jQuery, because when you are using any JS, at that time you must have to include your jQuery also. So you can use jQuery library. So you can copy paste this code, so you must have to include this jQuery library, right? You can remove this. Okay, now suppose we create one button here first, like button. And then we perform one onclick method and define one function one, right? Now you can write some JavaScript code and call this function, then function name. Our function name is function one, right? And here we display simple alert box. Hello world. right? Let's check that simple alert box will display or not. Then we will apply SweetAlert, right? Now we can open this file in our browser in Chrome. So here you can see when I click on this simple alert, then this alert box will display. But how to display this alert box with SweetAlert, right? This is not to look good and this is a simple alert box. So how to change this alert box with SweetAlert? So here you can see we include this, we also created one button. Now we also declare a function also. Now how to use this SweetAlert, right? For SweetAlert you must have to use swal method. So here you can see we use swal method. So simply you can change this alert with swal. Now we can save and check it. Now we can refresh. Now here you can see this is how this SweetAlert will display. And suppose you want success button, you can also use this title with text. Suppose you can use this title with text, then you can copy paste this code. Now here is title and this is our some text. And also here you can see if you want some success icon, then you must have to use this. And here you can see you must have to pass third parameter like success, right? So when you pass this third parameter is a success, at that time this success icon will display. So here you can see. Now if you want to display here as an error, then error icon will display. So here you can see this is a error. This is simple one, right? You must have to use this. And here I share everything. And suppose you need to some confirmation. Whenever you need to delete any file, and before the delete, you must have to some confirmation. At that time, you must have to use this code, right? I already shared this code in my blog. So you can copy paste this code into your file and you can check this, right? Let's check that. So here you can see this confirmation dialog box will display, and if you click on this OK, then success will call. And if you click on this cancel, then you are safe message will display. So here you can see this is how you can confirmation dialog box will display. And here there is so many other options are available, like if you want to display your image, then you must have to pass this parameter like icon and pass your image URL, right? So you must have to use this code. And you can download this source code from my blog link. So I will share this blog link in my video description, so you will get easily from my video description, right? And if you follow this blog and if you are getting any error while setting this code into your website or into your web page, then please write it down your comment in comment section. And I hope you will like this video, and thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe our channel so you will get this type of useful video day by day. So thanks for watching and bye.